Thank you so much, Toastmaster Tanish, and good evening to one and all present here, to all the lovely Toastmasters and to the esteemed guests that we have today. Well, 2020 so far is the theme today, and I believe there are a lot of takes someone can have from the year 2020. It has been an off year for many. It has been a year of complete transformation for many. If you consider, I pay more attention to what one can gain individually in whatever time they have. So I'm going to talk about myself for my 2020. Well, 2020 is a time when you can either make or break anything. You have all the time in the world. If there's anything you've ever wanted to do, now is the best time to do it. Now is the time you can make the most out of anything. Next year, when all of this is done, we have the wonderful vaccine, and when we are back to the normal life, don't say that you didn't have time. Because that time, when you say that you didn't have, you actually lacked discipline, not time. So make the most out of 2020. And of course, we're going to have a lot of discussions about 2020 from the person who's going to take the meeting forward. But before that, the minutes of the meeting, of the previous meetings was passed by our secretary, Toastmaster Tanish. And I hope everyone had a look at it and consider it passed. Please show me a thumbs up if you all consider it passed. All right. Thank you so much. So a big round of applause for our secretary, Toastmaster Tanish. Well, moving ahead, we have a few guests over here. And I would like to know about, from them that when do they get to know about Toastmasters, and from where do they got to know about Toastmasters and all. So can we have guest Ayushi over here with us? Hi, Ayushi. Please introduce yourself to us, what you're doing, and how did you come to know about Toastmasters?
Hello. I'm really sorry. Huh?
It's okay.
Hi. Hello.
Yeah, we can. You're audible now.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. I am Ayushi. I am doing MBBS from Arjikar Medical College in hospital. And I heard about Toastmasters from a friend of mine. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ayushi. Thank you so much for being over here. We saw a guest named Rahul. I really like that name. That's why I really want to know that what are you doing and where do you get to know about Toastmasters?
Hey, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So yes, my name is Rahul Nair. I'm currently working at British Telecommunication. I did my graduation from St. Xavier's College, and I came to know about Toastmasters from my friend. So he's been part of Toastmasters for 2 years, I suppose. And this is my third session of Toastmasters.
Okay, Rahul, lovely having you here. I hope you enjoy the meeting.
Yeah.
We have Munish ji with us, guest Munish. He's been one of the most active guests we have had this lockdown. Please, guest Munish ji, please introduce yourself to us.
Good evening. I attended Toastmaster Kolkata 3 to 4 times. Whenever I attend the meeting, I learn every time. I find this club very lively. So I always wait for Friday. At Friday evening, I keep myself free 7 to 9. To attend Toastmaster Club, Kolkata Club, and I will miss if you go offline. I want that it should remain online always. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Munish ji. No matter how much you miss us going offline, trust me, we are all dying to go offline now. It's been too much of online. We just want to go to CCC now. Thank you so much, Munish ji, for being here and for giving those kind words to our club. Well, to take the meeting forward, we have someone called the Toastmaster of the Day, the Master of Ceremonies for today. And he's a very dear friend of mine. He's someone that if 2020 is something completely opposite, the Toastmaster of the Day is completely opposite. If 2020 is the most negative year, Toastmaster Deepak is the most positive person you're ever going to find. He's the prodigy of what you call as talent and hard work. And he laughs at everything, almost everything. He might be giving an evaluation, he'll laugh at that. Whenever someone introduces him, he can laugh at that. But his laughter is what you know, just nurture this positivity so much, and to take the meeting forward, to conduct the meeting forward, I would like to introduce the Global Tech Master of District 41 and the Assistant District Public Relations Manager of District 41, Toastmaster Deepak. The stage is all yours.
Thank you so much. And good evening, Toastmasters and guests. It's almost September now. I want to know how this year has been for all of you. So I would like to have some volunteers. Who want to share? Yeah, sure, Rahul.
Like I just said, I've been trying to make the most out of this quarantine, lockdown situation, corona situation. But no matter what you say, you just miss going out, being with your friends, enjoying that, you know, outside world. There was a time once the lockdown got over around in May, mid-May. And I went for a drive with my dad outside my home. And I was just looking at the roads like this is something seen for the first time. I was driving in Park Street and I had no idea where Flurries was. That is the kind of change. There was a mental shift in my, you know, and it was completely insane to just see things that I have seen all my life, but not recognizing that this is something new. So 2020 has been that kind of a year for me. Anyway, I've tried to make the most out of it. And I know Corona isn't going anywhere. So we have to make the most out of it right now as well. But yeah, that is how it's been.
Thank you so much. Anybody else who would like to share? All right. No worries. I'll tell you how 2020 has been for the rest of the world. Can everyone see my blank screen right now?
Yeah, Deepak, you can.
Yeah, cool. Then. So we started off with New Year. Everyone was happy. But Australia was still burning. And World War III nearly got started. Coronavirus stopped the world. We had locust attack, Amphan, and currently a lot of states are being flooded with heavy rainfall. And it's just September now. We still have 4 months to go. I don't know what's coming towards us. So what's done is done. And we have no control over the future so much. So let's talk about tonight. Tonight we have a normal Toastmasters meeting, which is divided into three segments. First is prepared speeches. Remember when the lockdown was announced, we started preparing it for it by stocking up food and buying other essentials. And just like that, in prepared speeches, speakers prepare their speeches based on their objectives. Then we experience certain scenarios that we were not expecting and were not prepared for that. For example, Amphan, we acted based on our instincts and previous experiences. And in this segment is called Table Topic Session, in which Table Topic Master will give you certain topics to speak on impromptu. After that, we have Evaluation Session. You see, there are these journalists who go on the ground to tell you about the situation. What are the good things happening? What are not so good things happening? So you can act accordingly. Similarly, our GE, that is General Evaluator, will evaluate the whole meeting along with his or her team. So you prepare better for the next time. So let's proceed further and call our General Evaluator of the evening, somebody who loves public speaking and communicating. He loves helping people to become better version of themselves. And when asked how's 2020 been so far for him, he said he had a lot of canceled trips and works from home session. So please help me welcome Toastmaster Syed Fazle Farman with a big round of applause.
Thank you, Toastmaster Evening, for that wonderful introduction. I love the theme of the day. And it's truly apt because 2020 has been a year that is unlike any others. And I hope we never get a repeat of it, ever. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, all Toastmaster meetings are usually about speaking, communicating, and bettering ourselves. But how do we better ourselves? We better ourselves through constructive feedback and evaluation from our peers and colleagues.
What's wrong with you?
Sorry about that. For me to facilitate the evaluation that I want to do for this meeting, I will have a team of dedicated Toastmasters who will look after certain aspects of the meeting. I would like to introduce them, call them up to the stage now, and explain their roles and how they will conduct it. First up, all forward, Toastmaster Kirti Shetya for her role as a grammarian. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, Ms. General Evaluator, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Rahul, am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So it is my responsibility today as a grammarian to pay close attention to all the speakers, listen carefully to their language usage. I'll take notes of any misuse of the English language, as well as any outstanding words, quotes, saying, etc. As grammarian, it's also my duty to introduce you to the word of the day. And today the word is finesse, which means impressive delicacy and skill. And an example of using the word is, it was a disappointing performance that lacked finesse. I will note for every usage of the word of the day today, and I will encourage you to use it. And I will present my report at the end of the meeting when asked to do so. Thank you. Back to Mr. General Evaluator.
Thank you, grammarian, for that wonderful and succinct introduction. Next up, I'd like to call the A counter, Toastmaster Aman Shah.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. 2020 has given us a lot of opportunities, and most importantly, time to put our personal growth on track. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. As the A counter today, I will help you to communicate your ideas and thoughts better by taking you a step forward to becoming a better version of yourself. For this purpose, I will give all ears to some words that diminish the quality of our speech. Filler words like and crutch words, namely basically, actually, you know. I will also make a note of the fumbles and repetitions and present my report at the end when called upon to do so. Thank you, and back to you, Mr. General Evaluator.
Thank you, counter. Next up, I'd like to introduce the timer. This role will be played by Toastmaster Rahul Maheshwari.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. Well, if I'm the timer and the theme is 2020 so far, I think I am all your enemy today. Nonetheless, not being the enemy, the timer is someone who assists all the speakers by notifying them of the running time while they're delivering their speeches. We have three sessions in our Toastmasters meeting. The first one is the prepared speech session, where the speaker usually has 5 to 7 minutes. Then we have the table topic session, the impromptu session, where the speaker has 1 to 2 minutes. And finally, we have the evaluation session, where the speaker or evaluator has 2 to 3 minutes. I'll be flashing the green card at the end of the minimum time, the yellow card at the end of the mean time, and then the red card at the end of the maximum time. The speakers have a grace period of 30 seconds, both on the upper hand as well as on the lower hand, except for the table topics where they have it only for the upper hand. I'll be sharing my screen when the speaker reaches its minimum time to show the green card. So that's how it's going to be flashed to you all. And back to you, Mr. General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, sir. If you could show the audience the cards that you will flash, the green, red, and yellow?
Yeah, I'll just share my screen.
Thank you.
If you can see, this is the normal card. This one's the green card, which will be flashed at the end of the minimum time. The yellow card at the end of mean time, and then the red card at the maximum time.
Thank you so much, timer. I trust we will get your report at the end of the session. Next up, we have the WA counter, and this role will be played by Toastmaster Dr. Rupesh Singh. Sir.
Hi, very good evening, fellow Toastmaster and would-be Toastmaster in digital platform. Today, I will be the WA counter of the day. It is like when you're eating and you are getting something extra like rasgulla or ice cream, after that you will feel wow. Even if you talk about 2020, almost I believe I talk about Toastmasters, they put it wow in their life, in their professional or personal journey, because they got time to attain Toastmaster meeting more and more, and enhance themselves. Is it not a normal professional degree or something they got? But a lot of people I've seen, they become DTMs. I believe they should thank this pandemic in a positive way, because they got time, they get involved, they completed all the paths and all, right? That was a wow moment for them, the wow degree, I'll say. So today is my role to find the wow moment in this speech, which make your speech delicious from the listener perspective. So keep the tab, I'll keep the tab of all wow moment of the meeting. A wow moment is when a speaker makes an audience laugh, applaud, or leave them amazed. Only the three wow moment, rank 1, 2, and 3 of the meeting will be said while submitting the report. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Very appropriate that someone with a doctor in front of their name speaks from a library. So lovely to see you. Next up, we have the parliamentarian, and this role will be played by Toastmaster Tanish Agarwal. Sir, over to you.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator, and good evening, everyone. So today I am the parliamentarian for today's meeting, and today my role is to ensure that all the parliamentary norms are followed throughout the meeting. Specifically, I'll request members to show a virtual thumbs up when a member uses the word of the day. Avoid the usage of sex, religion, and politics in a derogatory manner, and use full forms of all Toastmaster-related terms like Project 1, Competed Communication, and different pathways like Dynamic Leadership, etc. And as we are having the meeting in an online platform, I request members to keep a few extra rules in mind. Firstly, do not unmute yourself unless it's your turn to speak, and do not write anything while a speaker is delivering his or her speech. I'll present my report at the end when called upon to do so. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tanish. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. My team and I will be back at the end of the meeting to deliver our report when the Toastmaster evening asks me to. Over to you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. General Evaluator. And it's time for our prepared speech session. And before calling our first speaker, let me call his evaluator, distinguished Toastmaster Rohan Nag, to read out his speech objective.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster of the day, sir, and good evening, fellow Toastmasters and future Toastmasters in our meeting today. The purpose statements are as follows. The purpose of this project is for the member to clearly define how Toastmasters envisions mentoring. The purpose of this speech is for the member to share some aspect of a previous experience as a protege. Member, please note and limit 5 to 7 minutes. All the very best for the speaker. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. So when I asked the speaker, how has 2020 been so far for him? And he sent me this GIF. It was Tony Stark. And I started, and for thinking deeply for a few minutes, I realized what he meant. He said, so if you get it, it's okay. If you don't, no worries. A lot of dark things are happening throughout this year. And with the speech title, People Who Believed Me and mentored by Toastmaster Shaurya Roy, please help me welcome our first speaker of the evening, Toastmaster Arvan Datta.
Thank you so much, Mr. Toastmaster of the day, and good evening, fellow Toastmasters, dear guests. Just by showing a thumbs up, please tell me, how many of you know how to ride a bicycle? Okay, a good number of people. Good. Now, some of you learn that on your own by falling and getting up by trial and error. And some of you had someone to teach you, say your brother or your father. Now remember, did your father only tell you how to ride a bicycle? Like get on the seat, start pedaling, go slow, use your brakes properly, and then just leave you on your own? Of course not, right? They not only told you on how to ride a bicycle, but they also showed you. Not only that, during your initial days, they used to hold the cycle from behind so that you don't go off balance and fell. And once you started pedaling, they used to walk or run side by side. And after you gained a good confidence and balance in the bicycle, without you knowing, they stopped holding the cycle from behind. And that's the time when you figured out you had the you believed in yourself that you could ride a bicycle, and in real life also you could. Ladies and gentlemen, to me, exactly that's how mentorship is, where a more knowledgeable, a more experienced person not only tells you the way, but shows you the way and goes the way with you till a point. I am only 21 years old, and the first mentor that I have had was at the age of 4. It was my grandfather. I was this new kid. I was this 4-year-old kid new into this world, and he was a retired army man in his early 70s. He was more fit in his early 70s than I ever was in my teenagehood, or even now. We were the best of the friends. Our bond was so strong. Every single day after I came back from school, my grandfather would take me to the ground where I would play with other kids. And he would just sit there and look after me. I remember that many a times I had gotten into fight with other kids. But my grandfather never allowed me to leave, to come back home with holding grudge or hate for someone. He always pushed me to solve the fight then and there. From a very young age, my grandfather taught me that holding a grudge against someone or hating someone will only harm ourselves, so we should not do that. And that was one of the most important learnings that I've ever gotten in my life. Back in the days, every single day, I would desperately wait for 9 p.m. I would finish my day's task very early. I would have my dinner very early and just wait for 9 p.m. to happen, because 9 p.m. was my prime time with my grandfather. That was the time he would tell me stories from his army days. It was stories of wars. It was stories of honor, courage, bravery. He told me stories from the best of mankind to the worst of mankind, and that had a huge impact in my young mind. Unfortunately, my grandfather passed away in 2013 when I was only 14 years old. But his learnings, those stories, are with me and will forever with me for the rest of my life. The next mentors in my life are my parents. Well, my father is one of the most hardworking, humble, and down-to-earth person I know. From a very young age, he has always taught me to be independent. He has always encouraged me to make my own decisions. He always welcomed and supported my decisions. Many a times, those decisions turned out to be miserably wrong, but I learned a lot from them too. And even after failing, my father supported me. He has taught me that there's more to this life than just earning money and being happy on your own. He has taught me to be there for people when they need me, not because I expect anything out of it, but because it is our responsibilities as human beings to be there and help each other in times of need. Then comes the most important person in my life, my mother. Now, my mother is like every other mother in this world, the best. She is the most loving, most caring, most supportive, and the sweetest person I know. She has always been there when I came first, when I came last, when I needed her, when I did not know that I needed her. You always need your mother. And she has always supported me. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is not possible to point out each and every single thing that I have learned from my parents, but everything I am today and everything that I will become in the future will be because of my parents and the lessons that I have learned from them. If I am talking about my mentors in life, I definitely should talk about my mentor in Toastmasters, Toastmaster Shaurya Roy. The very first day I attended a Toastmaster meeting in Kolkata Toastmasters Club, I attended as a guest, I saw him evaluating a speech. And I quickly realized that that's something I want to be like. The very first day I listened to him delivering a speech, I became a fan of his content. And believe me, the very first day I was when I was inducted into the club as an official Toastmaster, after the meeting ended, I quickly approached him and asked him to become my mentor. He agreed. Now, he always pushes and motivates me to do the things that I am scared of. You people, public. Speaking in front of the public is something that I was scared of, but I can proudly say that not anymore because of him. He has always pushed me. I reach out to him for advice on a regular basis. From what should I name my speech to what should I write into it, I ask him everything. But no matter how dumb or stupid or silly of a question I have asked him, I have always gotten a reply, a positive reply. Some questions he answers then and there, some he says, that will come with experience. So he asked me to be patient. I remember after my icebreaker speech, I quickly rushed to him and asked him, how can I improve? He did not tell me then and there. He just told me that it was good and that I should never stop going to the stage again. I should never stop going to the stage. And I haven't stopped ever since. Ladies and gentlemen, I am only 21 years old. And I know that as I move forward in life, in my career, I will meet a lot of other mentors. And all of the learnings that I have from my previous mentors and all of the learnings that I will have from my future mentors will always be valuable to me. And one day when I become a mentor, I shall pass those on to my mentees. There's this one thing common in all of the mentors that I've got, that they all believed in me. And I shall believe those who choose me as their mentors. Because ladies and gentlemen, a mentor is someone who believes in you at a level higher than you believe in yourself. What do you say, Mr. Toastmaster of the Day?
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Anirban. And before moving forward to our next speaker, let me call upon his evaluator, Toastmaster Mohit Balla, to read out his speech objectives.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the Day, and good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. So today, the speaker, Toastmaster Gurpreet, is delivering his Level 2 Project 1, which is Understanding Various Styles of Communication. And the purpose of the project is for the member to understand various styles of communication and identify his primary style. And the purpose of the speech is for the member to share this impact of his or her own style on the others. Timer, please note that timing is 5 to 7 minutes. And all the best to the speaker. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much. So when I asked the speaker how's 2020 been so far for him, he said, I have mastered the art of dishwashing and bargaining with vegetable vendors. So for those of you who don't know him, he's an actor and acts in movies. So such a big person, but so down to earth that he washes dishes and goes out himself to get vegetables. Man, I'm really humbled. And with that, please help me call our next speaker with the speech title, One Flight Cancelled, mentored by Toastmaster, distinguished Toastmaster Archana Tiwari, Toastmaster Gurpreet Singh.
Yeah, before I start, am I audible? Okay. I was sipping the last of my coffee and handing over the charge to the next person on duty when the phone on my desk rang. My watch confirmed it was 12 a.m., time for me to go home after a hectic day at work. Now, when you work for one of the leading news channels in the country, work is indeed hectic. And sudden calls signal emergency. What was this call for? Good evening, Madam President, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. Gurpreet, yes? Go to Delhi Airport to report about the Air India crisis. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you remember, in the year 2011, Air India suffered major losses to the extent of 8,000 crores and had to cancel many national and international flights. However, I was elated because all this while, over the last 6 months in office, I had merely been doing back office job, so much so that I had created a cavity in my own chair. This was my opportunity to make a mark as a correspondent. In less than 20 minutes, I used the official software to book a cab, a camera person, and in less than 30 minutes, we were taxiing down the road to the airport, lest we should miss the sound bites of passengers and their problems due to cancellations. We reached Indira Gandhi International Airport at 10 past 1. And I dashed towards the digital board to have a glance at the number of Air India flights, either delayed or cancelled. Realization dawned upon me that that night, except the one flight to Canada, which was cancelled, all other flights were on time. I looked at my camera person. He looked back at me. And in the very next instant, we were on the same page. We needed a story at any cost. So at 25 minutes past one, we were looking for passengers of that one flight to Canada, which was cancelled. And just then, I spotted an old man, perhaps in his 70s, in loose-fitting clothes, with a turban on his head. Considering the Punjabi population in Canada, I was convinced that I had got my first bite. I ran towards this gentleman. And without beating around the bush, the amateur reporter and me asked him a nonsensical question. Sir, how do you feel now that your flight has been cancelled? This gentleman was taken aback. He looked back at me and said, how would you feel if I didn't answer your question? Thankfully, my camera person intervened at the right moment and tried to calm this gentleman down. He tried to win his trust by sharing his concern. I stood behind trying to absorb the tricks of the trade. But that night, I learned some of the greatest skills of communication. While I adopted the direct style of communication, which implies coming to the point at once without beating around the bush, this situation required a different approach, perhaps the one adopted by my camera person. The supportive style of communication, which requires one to be patient, sympathetic, and cooperative. Anticipating the needs of others is the key aspect of supportive style of communication, and my camera person exhibited finesse in exhibiting it. And that got us our first bite, no doubt. It also saved us our jobs. Now, with one bite in store, we were greedy for more. So we stood under the digital board trying to analyze the situation. And just then, my camera person casually remarked, why don't we fake a bite? Now, before I could respond to that, he pointed at gate number 3 and said, go, approach that gentleman out there and try to initiate a conversation. Now, I spotted a boy, perhaps in his early 20s, standing with a lady who I presumed to be his mother. This lady was kissing him on the forehead and conducting the goodbye rituals. Perhaps this boy was going abroad for further studies. But just then, the lady held the suitcase and walked inside. Wrong assumption on our part. Nevertheless, I approached this gentleman. And very methodically, I tried to engage him in a conversation. I created a friendly and non-threatening environment in which I asked him, rather I told him, you know, mother-son partings are always emotional. Delhi is a new city for me, and I miss my mother in Calcutta. Now, the moment I said this, this person was on board with me. After that, we had a long conversation where he spoke and I listened. And what came out of the conversation was that this gentleman was here to see off his mother, who was flying to Australia to visit a distant relative. So in a short span of time, an anonymous relationship had cropped up. And so much so that he faked the bite for us, saying that his mother was due to fly to Canada, but couldn't do so because of the plane cancellation. So the government was made a scapegoat, but I understood that my style of communication has to be initiating and supportive. Today, I'm a teacher, and I use the initiating and the supportive style of communication in my classroom to engage my students. I've created a friendly atmosphere where my students can share their issues, even matters of breakup and patchup. Ladies and gentlemen, that night in 2011 was a hell of a night. The sun was already out when I returned to my apartment. My flatmate was watching the 8 a.m. news, and he greeted me on my first appearance on national television. I was ecstatic, and as I lay down to rest, my mind drifted to a different sphere of communication. That night taught me that communication is a pill, and we are doctors. While some pills work on all, some pills don't. So to be able to understand that which pill at which time will help the patient recover is the true hallmark of a true communicator. What do you say, Toastmaster of the day?
Well, thank you so much, Toastmaster Gurpreet. That was a wonderful, wonderful speech. And moving forward, before I call the next speaker to the podium, let me call his evaluator. His evaluator, distinguished Toastmaster Achyuta Tiwari, to bring out his speech objective.
Good evening, everyone. I hope I'm audible. I'm not being able to connect to video due to some network issues. I will fix that before I deliver my evaluation.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. The purpose of today's speaker is to make sure that the member practices developing a change in management plan. Also, the purpose of this speech is for member to share some aspect of how that change was implemented and how it was brought forward. I request the timer to please note that the time limit is 5 to 7 minutes, and all the best to the speaker. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And when I asked the speaker how has 2020 been so far for him, he said, it's amazing. I'm loving it, just like my project speech today, learning how to manage change. Well, those of you who don't know, he's an influencer and talks about communication. If you don't follow him, you are missing out on a lot. With that, with the speech title, Generation Gap, and mentored by distinguished Toastmaster Siddhartha Churiwal, please help me welcome Toastmaster Naren Agarwal.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster of the day. What is the only permanent thing in the world? Would you guys like to take a guess in the chat box? What do you think is the only permanent thing in the whole world? What's that one thing that's permanent? Thank you very much. Change, my friends, is the only permanent thing in the world. One who embraces change goes through life smoother than the one who doesn't. But change is painful, you know. It's uncomfortable and sometimes irritating. But that is only when you look at change from a cost perspective. But change is pleasurable, joyful, and playful for the creative and adventurous. Yes, old is gold, but even gold needs some polishing to keep shining. That's when I figured, when I joined my family business about a year and a half to 2 years ago. I was so lucky and felt wonderful to have a platform to step into and truly recognized my privilege. But I also saw so many opportunities of taking the business to the next level and improving the organization. Organization in a way that we could help enhance the way we work for our team and also the members and the customers. Dear folks, business is no joke, but business is a real-time game. All games are fun, but all games involve change. My biggest challenge was going to be handling generation gap in my business and remolding my father's style of management to my own. The way my team worked under my father, that they were not going to be working the same way under me. It would be different. Initially, for the first 6 months, I just shadowed my father and grasped all that was happening without having a responsibility or even taking a decision or making changes. But then came a point where I had to take on a role and head the sales and marketing wing of the business, which also meant changes were coming. Don't know for the better or the worse, but coming for sure. The first thing I had to do was implement a new software usage for our on-field sales force. This was a gargantuan task because I noticed everybody was going to be resistant to this change. It was a complete transition from paper trail to digitalization of the sales force process. But the benefits were immense. I had a bunch of meetings with the software company, finally negotiated well. They were ready for their support and I was ready for the launch. But oh well, my sales team was not as ready and excited as I was. This would fail without their support, and I knew I needed some grit. As we took off, many interruptions such as false data, software usability, technical issues, etc., etc., started creeping up. Throughout this process, I kept pushing to get things done, going past all troubles and resistances. Finally, after months on end, I got it done. But even though I managed to create the change, I realize now in retrospect, I was not a good change manager. Looking back, this is why they were probably scared of the generation gap, because change is not handled well by many leaders, including the past me. Three mistakes that I made and how my change plan would look now if I had to redo it. Mistake number one, I introduced the changes forcefully without alignment and without getting my teams in. What I need to do was I needed to sell this idea to them. I needed to show them what is in it for them and do it as a joint project. That would cause less resistance and make the journey gentler and faster for all. I could probably have a joint meeting with all, orient them together before rolling out the project to ensure that we co-create this project. Mistake number two, abrupt changes. As soon as something was not working, I used to make small frequent changes quickly and abruptly. What I should have done in retrospect, I should have created a systematic change plan, which was well thought out and kept on track. I would probably create a month by month advancement plan and keep the team updated with the progress so they know where they are, they know where we have come to and how much farther to go. They feel connected with the project. I feel it's better to create 80% change that lasts rather than going for 100% perfection, but that falls apart after a couple weeks. For a new system to last, it has to be stable, not abrupt. Lastly, third mistake, expecting one-time results and not being patient. I now realize change is a process that requires orientation, reorientation, and support. I should support struggling members instead of instructing and telling. It's okay to listen to them for solutions so that they get comfortable in coping with the change as well. Part of change management is also learning the art of patience. All in all, this project brought to my notice how I could be a better change manager of a generation gap in my business. And this was by aligning the team before changes, following a systematic change plan, and also patiently participating in the process of change while providing support. Going forward, I will be sure to implement my learnings from this project. Change is a must, but it can be handled choicefully. Change is hard, but it can be done with ease. Change is dynamic, but needs a plan. Nonetheless, change management requires finesse. What do you say, Toastmaster of the Day?
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Naren. And all the three speeches were really fantastic, unlike 2020. And so now we move on to our next session, which is table topic session, which will make you think on your feet and speak. And I really love this session because it's full of surprises, just like 2020. So when asked our table topic master, how has 2020 been so far for him? He said that his professional course exam has been postponed. His college has already abandoned him. And he had not been able to do thing he loved the most for the last 4 months. He meant football mostly. And he couldn't call it the best year, but he hopes that it gets better. So, and I know this speaker personally very well, the table topic master very well. So let me just share my screen with you for a second. Yeah, everybody can see my blank screen now? Okay, so our speaker started off his year with like this, and he's currently like this. And I did not take this picture, it's on YouTube. It's a thumbnail of a meeting. So, with that, please help me welcome our table topic master of the day, Toastmaster Vishesh Mehra.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Deepak, for sharing that horrendous picture of me. By the horrendous picture, I mean the one on the right, not on the left. So, table topic. This is something
I love a lot. And the love of this section of a Toastmaster meeting has grown through the years, as I could slowly and steadily get better at it. And how did I get better at it? There is only one way: coming again and again on the stage, on the podium, and speaking on a topic. Everybody has a lot of ideas when they hear a topic, but the major trick is to organize those thoughts properly and to present them in a coherent manner to match the topic. And this finesse only comes when you keep coming back to the stage. So I suggest each and every one of you, if you want to get better at table topics, you need to keep coming back to the stage. You need to keep taking part. You need to keep speaking. So, just like the year 2020, I'll throw not challenges, but topics at you. And hopefully you can catch them properly and speak on them. Well, each topic should be spoken on for 1 to 2 minutes with a 30-second grace period only on the upper end. I will only repeat the topic once. Nobody from the audience should prompt the speaker by using the chat box in the Zoom call. Guests can take part in this section. So please take up this opportunity. Please try to speak up. And for the guests, there's an added advantage that you can change your topic only once. But every advantage has a small disadvantage, that you cannot change the second topic. You have to speak on the second topic given to you. So, ladies and gentlemen, are you excited? Come on, let me see smile. Are you excited? Amazing. So, initially I would try to ask for volunteers. You could raise your hand using the Zoom call option. But if I don't see volunteers, I can pick anybody up. I am a mini Kim Jong-un here. I have a dictatorship. I can pick you up and say, you have to speak and you cannot resist me. Well, do I have a volunteer initially, or do I have to pick somebody up? Come on, raise your hand. I can see Toastmaster Vandana. Toastmaster Vandana, can you unmute yourself, please? Good evening, Toastmaster Vandana.
Good evening.
The topic for you today is, for a minute there, I lost myself. For a minute there, I lost myself, Toastmaster Vandana.
This lockdown is something I just hate. Hi, are you up for a coffee? This is what was happening, actually, with most of us. And though I was trying to be very careful, but one day, 12th August, I'd got down with fever. And 5 days later, I realized that I was COVID positive. And that was a time when I realized that everything has fallen apart. What if I die? What would happen? And it was terrible, terrible thing. Just a feeling for those seconds when I realized that I was COVID positive, though I was free from the fever, but I realized that I was positive. Could you repeat the topic again? I've forgotten the topic. So whatever.
Ma'am, the topic is, for a minute there, I lost myself.
Yes, so for a minute there, I lost myself for a while because I did not know what to do. But then all the positive thoughts that we have heard from a lot of people, and especially in Toastmasters Club, that you utilize your time with, doing some good work, delivering your speech and everything. So that's what I did. I wrote a speech and delivered it last week, and I felt so much better. Yes, I was lost for a minute, but then I regained my confidence, myself, and everything back. So thank you so much for that topic.
Thank
thank you so much, Toastmaster Vandana, for sharing your experience. And it must have been a very difficult time for you, but it's so good to see you back on the stage, back amongst all of us, and hope that soon we see you in presence physically. Moving on, who wants to take the next topic?
Can I try?
Yeah, sure. So, welcome back, Toastmaster Tidyan.
Hello.
Hello. So the topic for you today is Believe to Achieve. Believe to Achieve, Toastmaster Tidyan.
Thank you, Table Topics Master. As I sit over here in my home, cozy, I think of a lot of things. And I think that a lot of things are in suspense, in flux. Everyone's waiting for something to happen. Everyone's waiting to be told what to do. Everyone's unsure. But I think that in life, if you want something to happen and you want to do something, you have to take charge and you have to set forth and make that thing happen. And to do that, you have to believe in yourself and you have to believe that you can make it happen. And I think probably the biggest example for this right now would be that so many research fellows, so many scientists in the world right now are trying to find a vaccine for COVID-19. And if someone, or if they didn't believe that they could in themselves, that they could do it, it probably wouldn't happen. Everyone in the world would be waiting for something to happen, but it would probably be a bad time for everyone. So I would like to reiterate that you must believe in yourself for it to happen. Thank you. Over to you, Table Topics Master.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Tidyan. It was so good to see you after such a long time. And you spoke very well on the topic, connecting it to the situation each and every one of us is facing right now. So very well done. Moving on. So, can I get hands? I would like to call upon Toastmaster Rahul Maheshwari for the next topic. As he's the timer, I'll be timing him and I will present my timing at the end of his speech. So Toastmaster Rahul, are you here?
Yeah.
So Toastmaster Rahul, your topic is intelligence is not enough. Intelligence is not enough, Toastmaster Rahul.
Do you know that it is a proven fact that people who want to perform well in their jobs, their IQ, their intelligence is not the only factor that supports their performance. There are a variety of things. There are a lot of things that are to be congruent with your intelligence as well. I'm not saying intelligence is wrong or it is less or it's less important, but it is not the only thing important. I recently read a book that told me that IQ is something that cannot be changed. Everyone is born with the same IQ, but there is another thing that can be developed. And if developed, it adds a lot of value to your personality. And that thing is emotional quotient, EQ. Whereas intelligence quotient is something that can help you perform at your job, can help you do your task with focus and with a lot of concentration. Your EQ is something that helps you manage a lot of things. It helps you manage you. Your IQ is something that if you use better, you can always excel. But what is helping you to make it better? That is your EQ. That is your emotional quotient. I'm not saying emotional quotient and initial intelligence quotient is the only thing. There are also things that are important, such as your gut, such as your instinct. Have you ever realized that there are things that are not in a very textbook manner, that are not supposed to be done the way it is always done? There are instincts, there are your gut feelings that help you do a lot of things, that help you achieve a lot of things. Just imagine MS Dhoni doing such variety in, on the field, coming up with such amazing ideas like keeping the fielder Shrishant, if you remember, in the fine leg. These are things that not just intelligence can teach you. These are things that your gut can also teach you. I gave you two options right now. That is emotional quotient and your gut, which is not, I won't say it is more important than your intelligence, but it is as important as your intelligence. So trust me, if you think textbooks are only going to take you where you want to be, that is not the only thing. You have to improve yourself, not just in your intelligence, but also a variety of things. A variety of things is what makes you a complete human being, what makes you a complete personality, that joins the piece of puzzle that is missing in your personality. And along with that, intelligence, your emotional quotient and your gut, your instinct is what makes you what you want to be. Back to you, Mr. Table Topic Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rahul, for that amazing table topic. See, ladies and gentlemen, Toastmaster Rahul is the example of what happens when you keep coming back again and again on the stage to speak on table topics. He's used this lockdown period to come back to the stage and take up the opportunity to speak on table topics. And we can see each and every week he is just getting better and better. And I am a bit scared, to be honest, because in the table topic contest, I have a worthy opponent. Now, moving on, I would like to call upon a guest this time. And in the chat box, I saw the guest Amrita. Guest Amrita, are you here?
Yes. Hi, everyone. Good evening.
Good evening, guest Amrita. So, the topic for you today is, when is lying a good idea? When is lying a good idea, guest Amrita?
I'm sorry, I did not get the topic properly. When?
When is lying a good idea?
Okay. Actually, I think the topic does not suit me much since I am a very honest person. Like, I prefer honesty most of the times. But yeah, sometimes we should be diplomatic in certain situations and see that according to the situation, we may have to lie to keep the condition better, as in not to distress the other person. It's not about, like, we should not be honest all the time. Sometimes it's okay to be diplomatic. I would want to keep it that way. And sometimes I think to maintain the situation and in respect of the other person, maybe it would be a good idea to lie. So everything is dependent on the situation. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, guest Amrita. It was a very good attempt on the topic. And this is your first time speaking in a Toastmasters meeting?
Yes. I have been a part as a guest in the previous meetings. Yeah.
Amazing attempt. Keep coming at it. Keep coming back to the meeting. And keep trying. You will surely improve. In my first meeting, I blanked out while delivering a table topic and stopped in about 40 seconds and couldn't say a word. You at least completed and gave a complete coherency. So keep coming back on table topics.
Sure.
It is very,
thank
very important.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
And in the case of lying, I've learned that table topics help us to lie better because you can come up with things on spot in a very good manner, and you can lie better. So keep coming back on table topics if you want to brush the skill of lying.
Definitely. Thank you.
Yeah. So moving on, I can see Toastmaster Kirti.
Thank you.
Good evening, Toastmaster Kirti.
So good evening, table topic master.
The topic for you today is, planning is as important as execution. Planning is as important as execution. Just master case.
Execution. Execution for me means deadline. Unless something is closer to deadline, it will not work for me. It can be an assignment in at work, it can be an assessment for a project, it can be a delivery at home, even a meal which has to be served at 1 p.m., for me, planning starts just before execution. So I'm not a planner, and it's never worked for me. And every time I plan something for too long, things don't work out for me. So I am not a person who can plan too much, but my execution is always in perfection. Why? Because I'm a person who knows how to get things done, even if I don't plan for it, or I have not prepared for it, or I don't have the intelligence of doing it. I know how to get things done. And I think that's what I sell even at work. Every time a question is asked to me in an interview, if you know a subject, if you know what this definition is, if you know how this code works, my answer is always, maybe I don't know how it works, but your work will be done. I know how to get the information when I need it. So for me as a person, you have to know your strength. My strength doesn't lie in planning. I have tried it many times and then I've given up because I know it doesn't work for me. I believe in execution. I believe that in getting the job done. And I believe that if I take a responsibility, it has to be done with or without planning. Over to you, Mr. Table Topic Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kirti. That was an amazing table topic by you. I am quite the opposite. I sit, I plan. I keep planning and I don't execute. I just keep planning. Someday, I hope that I also start executing my plans, try to make this world a better place. Well, moving on to the last table topic of the day. And I would like to call someone who's been standing for a while, and I'm sorry that I couldn't call you earlier. So, Toastmaster Munish, are you here? I can't hear you.
Yes, please.
Amazing. So Toastmaster Munish, your topic is the grass is green where you water it. The grass is green where you water it, Toastmaster Munish.
Grass is green when you water it? I couldn't get it.
I'll repeat the topic once more.
Where
you water. All right. So I'll change the topic. The new topic for you is it's human to err. It's human to err.
Good evening, everybody. It's human to err. That it's a human being that makes mistake. If you don't make mistake, you don't rise in life. Everybody make mistake. Everybody who ever start the business in the beginning, he knows nothing about the business. That's why we say the people, those who grow in life, they make mistake. When I started my business, I knew nothing about that. I made many mistakes. Even in my office, if somebody make mistake, I say it's human to us. We all are human beings. We make mistake. If you don't make mistake, how will we come to know that how will we grow in our life? In any field, whatever field you take, when you go to love sports, you will make many mistakes. And after some time, it will take you time to understand about the game. You will make many mistakes. And then you will come to know after a long time. Like we say, Rome was not built in a day. So whenever we make something in our life, we make many mistakes. When somebody starts a construction business, in the beginning, he knows nothing. Maybe if we make something, the building can also fall down in such a way. Because we can make that type of mistake, but we can say it's a human error. Sometimes while typing also, some people make a blunder. In journalism, sometimes in they write a word which can create a menace, but we are human and we make mistake. It's part of our life. Everybody makes mistake. Whenever in any my organization, anybody make mistake, I remain calm. I know that he's also a human being like me. That's why he made mistake. If this work is given to me, if I do, I can also make mistake. So I remain mum. Thank you. Over to the Toastmaster, please.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Munish, for that amazing table topic. We make mistakes to grow. The mistakes help us to learn. It becomes a point where we can use it as a reference and say to ourselves, I'm not going to do that again. And we can grow, we can learn. As you said, me being a sportsman, it is very important for me. If I make a mistake once, I can be forgiven. But if I make the same mistake twice, there's no forgiving me. So that's all from my side for today. Thank you for each and everyone who volunteered. It was lovely seeing so many new speakers taking up this challenge of table topics. Now, back to the very smiley, very happy Toastmaster Deepak Baid to tell us about the horrendous year 2020. Back to you, Deepak.
Well, thank you, Toastmaster Vishesh. And ladies and gentlemen, it's almost September now. And the whole year has been a roller coaster ride, except the roller coaster is just going down for most of us. And if I had to show you this year in pictures, it would be like this. Okay. So we started off our year with parties and resolutions and a lot of things. We were so happy in January, February. Then came March, suddenly lockdown happened. We just constantly look at the data, how many cases there were in our country every day, in our state every day. So many things happening in March. In April, it was 420. What do I say about it? April 420. May, June just made all of us cry. It was now too much for all of us to manage. But finally, in July, lockdown ended. But we were too surprised to look at the cases going up and up. And it's currently 77,000 cases every day. Too horrified. And September, so from like an hour, I'm so done. I will not be surprised even if a meteor comes in and just blow up everything. So from September, October, November, December, I just don't care it at all. Whatever comes. So please don't wake me up when September ends. And with that, please help me welcome our general evaluator for the evening, Toastmaster Shayad.
What an intro to follow up with, ladies and gentlemen. That's a hard bar to reach. But thank you so much, Toastmaster Evening. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we'll be conducting the evaluation section for the meeting. First up, I'd like to call forward Distinguished Toastmaster Rohan to give his evaluation of speaker number one, Toastmaster Anirban Datta.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is said that good mentors are like candles. They burn themselves to light the way for others. Good evening, General Evaluator, fellow Toastmasters, and Toastmaster Anirban, who told us about the candles that have lit him and made him what he is today. Anirban, let me share a few things that I thought you did really well today. First were your stories. You had wonderful stories, personal stories, stories exclusive only to you, about the various mentors who have shaped your grandfather, your father, your mother, and of course, Shaurya. And what I really liked about your stories is that you spoke of different aspects that you learned from each one of them. And these stories made your speech unique and relatable for me. Second were emotions. It is said that some of the best things in the world cannot be seen or touched, but can only be felt, and those are emotions. So when you were talking about your grandfather, when you were talking about your mother, your emotions could be seen. Emotions could be emanated from your expressions, and that reached me because I have learned from my grandfather. And for me also, my mother is the best. Wonderfully done regarding the emotions part. And last but not the least was your conclusion. Your conclusion focused on self-realization. You said in your conclusion that you have understood how important it is to mentor others. You have understood how important it is to believe in others, and that is exactly what you will do. And in your conclusion as well, you justified the title of your speech, People Who Believed in Me. And your conclusion was strong and robust. Very welcome. But Anirban, as we believe in Toastmasters, the biggest room in the world is a room for self-improvement. And my job as an evaluator is to help you in improving the speech. So here are certain points for your consideration. First was a call to action. A call to action was missing in your speech. So what you could have done is you could have told about the cycle story again. So ladies and gentlemen, the way somebody holds your cycle and helps you learn I want you to hold somebody else's cycle and help them learn. I want you to believe in someone else. That would have been a call to action for me as your audience member. Second was character conceptualization. You had wonderful characters, your grandfather, an army officer, your father, your mother, Shaurya. So you could have brought in a little bit of character through voice modulation and given definition to your characters. And last but not the least, your project objectives. Anirban, one of the project objectives states that how Toastmasters envisions mentoring needs to be stated in the speech. But that is something that was missing from the speech. You should have incorporated how Toastmasters gives value and importance to mentoring. But having said that, Anirban, your speech was absolutely crisp and smooth. Your stories, emotions, and conclusions were bang on. Bring in a bit of call to action, take care of your project objectives, and of course, work on your characters. And I'm sure that your mentor in Toastmasters is going to be super proud of you. All the very best to you. Thank you.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster Rohan, for that wonderful feedback and evaluation. Toastmaster Anirban, if I could add to what distinguished Toastmaster Rohan had to say, I loved your speech, but what I would have appreciated is a little more variety in terms of vocal texture and how you expressed your words. You had a lot of great content and the characters were superb and your content was excellent. But if you had simply used or modulated the voice that you were talking in, the impact of the words that you were speaking would be felt more significantly. For example, there was words of best of mankind, worst of mankind. Now that's a very powerful phrase. If you could modulate best of mankind, worst of mankind, or some variation or the other, the impact that we feel as an audience would be multiplied manyfold. Similarly, I felt like sometimes when you are talking about what someone has said to you or what you have said to them, you could have cut away certain parts and just got to the conversation or the dialogue directly instead of adding words which he said to me. Instead, you could just make it a dialogue or the conversation, which would make us feel as if we were in the room with you when you're talking to your mentor or your father who said, we have a responsibility to help people in life and so on and so forth. With that out of the way, sir, I think you did a great job. Thank you so much. We all benefited from that speech. Next up, I'd like to call forward Toastmaster Mohit Bhalla for his evaluation of speaker number two, Toastmaster Gurpreet Singh. Sir, over to you.
If you communicate, you just get by. But if you communicate effectively, knowing your own style of communication, you just can create miracles. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Gurpreet, for taking us down the memory lane to that one incident that helped you realize what your styles of communication are. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. What I really liked about Toastmasters Gurpreet's speech is the conversational style of speaking, the way he used lyrical language. He knew where to put in the pantomime, he knew where to exaggerate, and he knew where to put in the voice modulation, he knows where to put in the vocal variety. So his speech was a perfect melange of voice modulation, vocal variety, and it had humor. A lot of humor, peppered and sprinkled and compounded all through the speech. So kudos to you on having such an amazing mastery of content. Second, the practice spontaneity and humaneness. Even though it was a prepared speech, but then your character had that humaneness, the way you used directional strategy, the way you moved your head 30 degrees towards the left and then you moved your head upward while you were looking at the dashboard, or beat the time when you looked back 90 degrees at the time when your cameraman called. You know how to use the directional strategies and bring humaneness to your character. So kudos to you on that. And the third, what I really liked is the rate of speech. You know how to vary your rate of speech in order to create that effect. There were portions where you just rushed through your speech and created that excitement, that vitality. And there were portions when you were calm and composed. And at that point of time, it helped the audience to absorb the emotions. So basically, varying the rate of speech helps your audience to convey them, helps you to convey the emotion and impact the vitality. So kudos to you on varying and experimenting with your rate of speech. Well, every speech has got certain scope of improvement and so does yours. So let us just walk through some of the recommendations that will help to ameliorate yourself. The first one is the frown expression. Whenever you speak a dialogue or where in a portion, a grim part of a speech, there's always a frown expression attached to it.
wherein your brows tend to concentrate towards your forehead, and you, either your brows tend to concentrate towards your forehead or your brows just lift up. So I would just request you to pay heed on this frown expression and try and avoid it, because it kind of, it brings down the impact of your pantomime or your expressive speech. Second is the conclusion. Conclusion is something wherein we collect and reiterate whatever which we have spoken the speech, and we make the message explicit, or we assimilate the content that we have unveiled in the speech. But I felt that you introduced a new story towards the end of the speech. And a speech is supposed to be 360 degree speech, that when you start at a high note, you are supposed to end at the high note. It's always advisable. So if you could have used a rhetorical question like when is the last time you missed your flight, it would have created the impact. So summing it all up, it was an amazing speech. You have the mastery of content. Just heed on the frown expression and make your conclusion more concrete. It will help you to become an amazing speaker. All the best for your future speeches.
Thank you, Evaluator Mohit, for that wonderful evaluation. Toastmaster Gurpreet, if I could add a few things, sir. First of all, I loved your delivery. I loved your content. You were very confident and poised when you were on stage and making good use of the stage. One thing you could do, I know it's not related to specifically Toastmaster speaking, but since you were speaking away from the device from which we are picking up the microphone, right? Maybe perhaps you could invest in a small Bluetooth headphone, something which has a mic attached to your cloth or your neck, which would make the sounds you're making that much clearer to your audience. And we could pick up on the subtle cues that you're showing off, like highs and lows and so on and so forth. Maybe you could incorporate that. Second thing I want to add to you, sir, I loved your presentation. That's a given, right, sir? But what I would have liked you to incorporate is a few more visual words in how you're describing something. For example, remember when you said your cameraman said, hey, maybe we should go there, right? Maybe you could use my cameraman said in his heavy bassy voice. That could give us the impression that we know who your cameraman is. Or say when your cameraman was talking to the older person and you were standing beside him, you could describe yourself, me and my quivering self, or me with my knobby knees shaking at the core. That would make us feel like this is a visual impact we're getting. Okay, I feel what's going on here. So if you incorporate these visual cues, your presentation, which is already at a high level, will go to the next level from my perspective. And I think you'll do much better in your next speeches. Thank you so much, sir. Next up, we have evaluator number 3, distinguished Toastmaster Archita Tiwari. She will be evaluating speaker number 3, Toastmaster Naren Agarwal. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Before the timer starts, I would like to check an audio visual because I'm unsure a little bit about the. Thank you, Rahul. And we can now start. Remember, to change with a change in your life, or the change in your life will change your life. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, dear guests, and the CM of today. I don't mean Chief Minister, I mean the change manager of today, Toastmaster Naren. Toastmaster Naren, with that wonderful speech of yours today, you inspired all of us to make sure that we don't be scared of any change in life and go ahead and face it with our head on. Now, the things that I absolutely loved about your speech, let me start with the first thing. The first thing that I absolutely incredibly liked about your speech was personalization. Your speech today was all about I. And I don't mean I in a Salman Khan way, but I in a way that says impactful, inspiring, insightful. Your speech today had impact because you were able to communicate the message so directly and with so much conviction. It was insightful because it gave us an insight into your own mistakes and into your own professional life. It was inspiring because you told us how you overcame all of those mistakes in detail. The second thing that I absolutely loved about your speech was the fact that there was brilliant voice modulation. Today, your voice modulation was PPT, again, not PowerPoint presentation, but it had pace, pitch, tone used perfectly. When I say pace, pitch, tone, let me elaborate. When you were using the words, for example, when you said, and I quickly took my decisions without waiting for anybody, you were fast. But when you said, change, my dear friends, is the only constant, you were slow, which told us how brilliantly you used pace. Similarly, when you were high with the first part of quickly taking decisions and low with the change, your tone and your pitch were perfectly in sync.
The third thing that I absolutely loved about your speech today was the comfort and the ease of presence on the camera. Today, you were here to make sure that we all get the message you're trying to say, and you're not someone who's afraid of speaking in front of an audience. But like they say, change is the only constant, and therefore, a few changes that I would recommend in your speech today, starting with the first one, there were too many hand gestures. There was a part where you said, team in and team out. I could only look at your hands. And when you said, we have to do this together, I was focusing more on your hands than on your speech. So for me, that was a little too much. Second thing that I felt could have been done better in your speech today was the fact that there were not perfect transitions. When you moved from one mistake to another, or when you said business is no joke, but business is real time, and immediately after stop with the mistake that was missing. When you moved on from data to conclusion of 80% and 100% to your conclusion, three changes, the transition would have been better. And finally, I feel that the conclusion was a little abrupt. Even though it had concept, even though it was inspiring, it came all of a sudden when I wasn't expecting it. So I feel that if you can work on these three things, you are someone who always inspires us with great delivery. I'm sure your place is to go. With that, thank you, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, Madam, for that wonderful and succinct evaluation covering all the right points that I wanted to mention that you've mentioned. Now I can't mention anything. But, sir, what I would like to mention is that I loved your delivery, right? She hit all the right marks where your delivery was perfect. But one thing I would have liked to see in your speech is that you could have utilized a little bit of drama, a little bit of suspense to show us that, hey, I did this. This went wrong, but did I recover from it, right? You could have incorporated like these are the steps I did and ultimately through my hard work and grit, I recovered. Instead of telling us, hey, I recovered and these are the things I learned, you could have kept us in suspense finally. Did your company go under? Did you break even? Did you finally learn? Like you could have, we would have been like, wow, what's going on? Is he actually going to get to the end? So I felt instead, a little bit of humor, a little bit of drama, suspense could go a long way. Ultimately, sir, great job. Wonderful speech. Thank you. Next up, I believe I will be evaluating the table topic session. I'll get to the table topic evaluator after this. First up, I believe we have Toastmaster Vandana, if I'm not mispronouncing her. Madam, I loved your confidence, how you just jumped right in and said, let's go get a cup of coffee. You started off with a character and you started off with a personalization. That was wonderful. I loved it. Technical glitches happen. We sometimes forget topics. That's 100% fine. But the way you wrapped your story around the topic itself and didn't let go for even a second was amazing. So I liked your delivery, but I feel like your concept could have done, actually, no. I can't. It was a wonderful speech, madam. And your the concept that you were trying to get at where you had COVID and you recovered from it for a minute, I lost myself. I loved how you tied your story in with the topic and tied it off with a bow. So well done, madam. That was an excellent table topic speech. So kudos to you. Next up, I believe we have Toastmaster Trigian. His topic was belief to achieve. So I love your delivery. You're obviously very competent and comfortable in front of the camera and speaking. But what I would have liked is to have seen a few more specific examples. For example, I believe you actually got to the topic that you were supposed to speak about a minute into the speech. Maybe if you could start off with the example that you had already given, like where you had doctors trying to cure corona or cancer or cerebral palsy, or even if you gave certain examples of people who overcame adversity through the sheer power of belief to achieve something, or maybe the flip side, maybe it didn't happen. Maybe if you had stuck to a few more examples, specific examples, your speech could have been that much more powerful. But overall, it was very well delivered. Thank you. Next up, I believe we have Toastmaster Rahul Maheshwari. Intelligence is not enough. Sir, I loved your delivery, of course. You were a great speaker.
you could have used examples on what you're trying to talk about. You talked about IQ and EQ, right? We all know the, I mean, of course, now that you've explained it, we all know what those are, but maybe.
You're on mute, Toastmaster.
Sorry, where did I cut off? I'll start from the beginning. Yeah, obviously we know what IQ and EQ are, thanks to you, right? But maybe you could have given us specific examples of, say, your IQ can help us solve calculus, but can it help you defuse an angry girlfriend, right? You can be very smart in writing a book, but can you put a crying baby to sleep? That's where EQ comes in. Like, you can use real world examples to make the concept that you're trying to impress upon your audience come to life. And those examples, I believe, are all around us, right? But ultimately, I feel like you did an excellent job in actually conveying to us what you were trying to say. So well done, sir. I think next we have guest Amrita. Madam, that was a wonderful try for a guest. I loved how you just jumped right in without any hesitancy. From the moment he said the topic, you just went for it and said, this is not me. I am not this person. I don't like lying. But you didn't give up. I liked how you just had a good flow. You're obviously confident and you had a good grasp of language, as it were, and the way to speak. So I sincerely hope you will become a Toastmaster and come back to the stage so you will become a champion speaker in the future. Thank you.
Sure, thank you.
Next up, I believe we have Toastmaster Kirti. Planning is as important as execution. I loved your delivery was impeccable, madam. But I would have liked if you had thrown in something unexpected, something that put a zing on it, right? We all know that, fine, we get the idea that you don't like planning, you just love execution. Maybe you could have thrown in something humorous or something off tilt, which could have catched like, hey, what's she saying? Like, for example, this is just off the top of my head that I didn't plan my wedding. My husband didn't plan my wedding. I just told him and we just did it. Something off chart, something all left of field could have captured the audience's attention better and made it more memorable for us as a speech. That's my suggestion to you, madam.
Thank you.
Next up, I think we have Toastmaster Manish. Or guest Manish.
Guest, I guess. He's a guest, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Yes, please.
Okay. Sir, I loved how you're obviously a strong speaker and you peppered your speech with personal anecdotes, use of examples. You were standing up straight. You were giving it in ghost posture and your speech was very well delivered. One thing I would like you to do is work on the ending and leave it with a different touch. For example, when you reiterate that it's human to ear, right? So people who make mistakes in your company are obviously going to mess up and you try not to be angry with them. Maybe instead of ending with that, you could have ended with, he's human as hell, he's human as well, so I'm not going to get angry with him, even if in my mind I'm strangling him with my hands. Like if you had ended with the imaginary situation, which put a twist on how you're not trying to be angry or added some touch of humor to it, your ending would be that much better, sir. Thank you. Overall, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for all the table topic speakers, the prepared speakers, and the evaluators who came on stage. Thank you so much, everyone, for making this session so vibrant and colorful. Next up, I think we will go to the grammarian, Toastmaster Kirti, for her report on things we spoke about well and areas we can improve. Madam, over to you.
Thank you so much, Mr. General Evaluator. I've been observing the meeting very carefully and I'm amazed at how come I didn't notice in the previous meetings how beautiful English language has been used in our meetings. I had so much to note in terms of good usage that I tried to, you know, I had to cut short of my poor usage, but I'll still read out a few that I noted. So unlike any others will be in like any other. I am all your enemy today will be I am the enemy today. Gonna be should be going to be. told you on how to write, told you how to write. There will be no on there. It was stories of war. It should be probably there were stories of war. Some good usage I noted. Part of change management is also learning how to be patient. You must believe in yourself for it to happen. IQ is something that cannot be changed. Join the pieces of puzzle that makes your personality. I have a worthy opponent. Use of vocal texture, humor, peppered and sprinkled all over your speech. And I love the way Archana used III and PPP, PPT. So that's something I noted. And the word of the day was used thrice today. So that's for my report and back to General Evaluator of the day.
Thank you so much, madam. It's amazing how vibrant and rich this language is in terms of how we can find so many different avenues to convey the same message. And thank you so much for taking the time to actually observe and listen to all of us. Next up, we have the A counter, Toastmaster Aman Shah.
Thank you, sir, General Evaluator. Toastmaster Gurpreet, Toastmaster Naren, Toastmaster Vishesh Mehra, DTM Rohan Nag, DTM Archita Tiwari were flawless as usual. Guest Amrita had 5 hours. Toastmaster Kriti had some ums. Toastmaster Tanish had some us. Deepak had 1 hour. Toastmaster Anirban had 7 hours. Toastmaster Rahul had 2 hours. That's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure not finding my name in that list, but it's great. Next up, I think we will call upon the timer who will make sure that we stayed within the limits. Toastmaster Rahul, could you please give us your report?
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. Good evening once again to all of you all. Well, all the speakers were on time and are eligible for voting, apart from guest Amrita, who took 39 seconds to deliver her table topic. And apart from her, every speaker is eligible to get voted. Back to you.
Thank you so much, timer. Exactly the hallmarks of a well-prepared, well-rehearsed, and well-choreographed event. Next up, I'd like to ask the WOW counter, to come forward and give his report, sir. Over to you.
Hi, very good evening again. I believe today I realize that WOW counter role is almost difficult in a digital environment. So I don't have any chance to look up the face. I believe less than 5% were in video. So they are laughing, they are getting excited, or they are getting angry or annoyed with the speech, really don't know. So most of the wow moment, I really believe on my gut feeling, what I realize or might be just testing for my listening capabilities. So just to start with, so I believe whenever name of mother comes, I get emotional. And when Toastmaster Anirvan start talking, like how her mother start, you know, like a other's mother when she's, you know, caring, loving, that made me remind again Mora Varrana, who says, "Maine bulandiyon ke bade se bade aasman chua, maane jab uthaya god mein, maine burandon ke bade se bade nishan chua, maane jab uthaya god mein to aasman chua." That means I touched a lot of milestone, professional milestone in my professional life, but my wish to touch the aasman happened, the sky happened, my mother took me in lap. That is the third wow moment. Second wow moment, when Toastmaster Archita Tiwari DTM said impactful, insightful, inspireful, and shown how the voice modulation should happen. And topmost wow moment happened. At that time, a lot of videos, I don't know, people started switch on when Toastmaster Deepak Bhai, they started showing the picture along with the month. Thank you very much, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, sir, for that wonderful report. I think we'll call upon the parliamentarian next, Toastmaster Tanish Agarwal.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. Good evening, everyone, once again. So most of the parliamentary norms are followed throughout the meeting. That's all from me, sir.
Thank you, sir, for that very short and useful report. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think I should go over the meeting as a whole for you, since we've done with most of our role players and evaluators. First up, you guys started on time. The meeting started impeccably right on the dot, and it was
very well carried out by the Sergeant at Arms, who did a well, good job in stating all the norms, the rules, the regulations, and making sure we transitioned from before the meeting to the meeting. So well done, sir, with your job. Mr. President, who is the current treasurer, who's acting as your acting president today. I loved how you had a very strong opening. You set the energy and the tempo for the meeting from there and never let it back down from there, right? So that's a very crucial role for someone who opens the meeting. You have to set the energy level, not just the agenda, the energy level. So you did that wonderfully, sir. Next up, I love how you gave the floor to every single guest that you could see on the list. Oftentimes, that's usually the push that a guest needs to transitioning from a guest to become an actual paid Toastmaster. So that's a very job well done where you managed to involve them into your club proceedings. So good job, sir. I hope you guys proceed and continue with that tradition or practice. Toastmaster today, what can I say about you? You, it's not an easy thing to say about someone who set the bar so high. You did a wonderful job where you started with the open-ended question and you kept the proceedings lively and warm. You managed to make it seem so warm, welcoming, and lighthearted that I felt like the whole proceeding and everyone who's here, who's not a Toastmaster or a Toastmaster or wants to be a Toastmaster, wanted to get involved with the meeting. So well done to you. And obviously, since you had a steady stream of images to showcase your fellow Toastmasters, it was obvious that you guys have a warm self of community that's obvious to everyone. And I loved all the photos that you managed to pick out, including the some of the less flattering ones. So good job to you, sir. All the role takers and accounters did wonderfully well. I'm very glad that the grammarian, the R counter, and the timer did it. Obviously, the timer. Next time, I suggest that when you do become act as the timer, you just start displaying the timing cards for the audience to benefit from. Sometimes you have people who won't obviously know the card that you're trying to show, or it'll be different. I'll have a different card, you'll have a different card, and so on and so forth. So it's sometimes that I'm the timer, I'll do this. So you just start displaying the cards when you're introducing your role.
Sir, you're on mute.
Sorry. Table Topic Master, first of all, lovely presentation of your session. You started off with a good tempo. I love the King Jong-un reference. You did everything right. You got the audience going. That's what I loved about it. But sorry, two things. One thing is, since we're in a virtual environment and it's often difficult for everyone to pick up on certain things, some of us may not have good headsets, some of us may not have that audio, like audio breaks up, right? I'm speaking, you might not be, you just saw me on mute. So sometimes it's difficult for people to catch you on one go, right? So if a Table Topic Master, something you could do, maybe, possibly, you could think about it, is write the topic in the chat box or repeat it twice or thrice for the person to catch. Because ultimately, in a physical environment, we won't have that problem, right? You give someone one topic and they have to speak about it, that's it, done. But in a Zoom meeting, since it's virtual, we have to make certain accommodations. So I believe you could use that, like you write in the chat box or say it twice or thrice, or one thing you could do is use PowerPoint presentations where you give an image, right? Where you ask them to talk about an image or throw some wordplay out there. Like if the visual medium is very powerful nowadays, and you could use that to your fullest extent, because we won't always have this when we go back to the physical meeting. So I highly encourage you to think about this, maybe incorporate it in the future. Also, second is, since you had a theme, right, 2020 so far, right, I loved your topics, but I felt like maybe you could have kept the topics more relevant with the theme right now, right? Maybe keep it relevant to not, it doesn't have to be corona related. We're done with corona stuff. We're done with pandemics. Maybe time, year, progress, change, something so forth. Like you could have used plays on this, but your topics were excellent because they had, you didn't shoebox people in, you gave them scope to talk about whatever they want to talk about. So that was excellent, sir. Well done. Overall, sir, thank you so much. I believe that it was an excellent meeting from start to finish, and I'm really glad you were a general evaluator. Well done to all of you, and I hope I'll be back here again in any role that you might need me to. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster Evening.
Thank you so much, Mr. General Evaluator. If you were thinking I was done, no, I'm like 2020. I'm not done yet. I have a video to show it to you about what 2020 is like in a gist. Okay. So So you see, just a second. So you see, there's so many things happening in just one video. He gets bowled, then he gets hit by the ball, then the ball goes off the building, so he gets out twice. And now he looks for the ball. This is just like 2020. There's so many things happening and it's too difficult to process what is going on actually. But you know, look at the positive side as well, that there are so many people, for example, Ambani's, who became the fourth richest person, and Zoom itself became richer than top 7 airlines in the world combined. And there are many other people who have started out their venture mostly because of this lockdown. So whatever it be, good, bad, sad, happy, just make sure that you enjoy most. And before signing off, let me now call the standings president of the evening, Toastmaster Rahul Maheshwari, to take over. And meanwhile, voting link has also been given in the Zoom chat. Please go and vote. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Deepak. Well, Toastmaster Deepak, you use your tech skills to make a lot of posts, flyers for us to conduct these online meetings. But sometimes it is just a sin for people who are in that video. So, but anyway, I must say it was a very well conducted meeting, Toastmaster Deepak, and not just the meeting, each and every speaker, each and every evaluator, the table topic speakers, I think everyone was so precise and so well prepared for the job, for the role they had today. It was completely terrific to see such an amazing meeting, such an insightful general evaluation session, a very well prepared team out session, Toastmaster of the Day session by Toastmaster Deepak, then the table topic session, none other than by the champion himself, Toastmaster Vishesh. Thank you so much for conducting that table topic section so beautifully. And to our general evaluator, also our Toastmaster from Bangladesh, Gulshan Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Syed. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Syed, for taking our time and taking this general evaluator role. You surely added a lot of value to our club right now and to all the speakers who came to the podium. Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster, Table Topic Master, the General Evaluator, coming to the speakers who are so fabulous. I mean, we had a star-studded meeting today, to be precise, to be honest. I mean, Toastmaster Anirban, Toastmaster Gurpi, Toastmaster Naren, and then in evaluations, we had distinguished Toastmaster Rohan, who has been attending the club meeting after so long. It was amazing to have you, distinguished Toastmaster Rohan. Distinguished Toastmaster Archita, thank you so much for that insightful evaluation. Not to forget our Toastmaster from Elite Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Mohit. Thank you so much for taking our time and coming and being a part of our meeting, taking up this evaluation role. You've surely done a great job and added a lot of value to our speaker and to the meeting both. Well, the voting links are out. Please take out 15 to 20 seconds and just cast your vote. I'll do the same right now. All right. While the others are filling their forms,
check WhatsApp.
Yeah, I've got it, Deepak.
Okay.
While the others are filling their forms, let's have a few guests to get the guest feedback. Just like any speech, feedback is like the breakfast of champions. For any meeting as well, the feedback is what makes us get and makes us do better meetings for the next time. So can we have a few guests to give their feedbacks and their evaluation actually about the meeting as a whole, how they like the meeting and stuff.
Shall I speak?
Toastmaster Munish, we are not being able to hear you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Now you're audible.
In the beginning also, I told you, I enjoy attending Toastmaster Kolkata meet. It's incredible.
I learned something today again. Whenever I attend this meet, I wait for every time the Friday I should attend this meet. It's a lively meet. Really, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, guest Munish. And it is lovely to have you as the guest every time. I mean, you come to our meeting, you give us feedbacks regularly, you take up table topics regularly, you are so active. Thank you so much for coming and being a part of our meeting. You surely add a lot of value to us. Is there any other guest? Is there any other guest who would love to give their feedback? Come on, I saw a lot of guests today. Can we have another guest? Okay.
Yes. Yes, this is Kamrul from Bangladesh.
Hi, I'm sure you're Toastmaster Kamrul.
Yeah, I'm from Gulshan Toastmasters Club, Bangladesh.
Lovely to have you. Please, your feedback, sir.
First of all, I would like to say that I'm a silent, guest, because it is the third, I think, I'm joining Kolkata Toastmaster, but I didn't talk. And it's just Syed Fazle Faran. We're in the same club. So I would like to say that it's actually amazing. It's stupendous what I feel. And that's why I try to join here. If I have free time, I would like to join here. Just because there's lots of fun, lots of things to learn. Lots of things I'm getting from here. And I would like to, even believe or not, already I have written a lot of things today. But whatever new thing I have got, I have written. Because it's the part of learn. So I love this session and I'll keep trying to join the next session also. So that's all from my part.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kamrul. Please, no, don't just be a silent guest now. Take up a table topic and please let us know how great you are with your oratory skills. Well, it's time to move on to the results. We had a very splendid meeting, but it's now time to make the results official. And we'll start with the ancillary role players. And among the auxiliary role players, that is the grammarian, the R counter, the timer, bar counter, and parliamentarian, I'm glad to say that Toastmaster Kriti, our grammarian, has won the best auxiliary role player. Ma'am, you did a great job. Okay, that was quite a reaction, ma'am.
I'm so glad.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for noticing those amazing keywords, those grammatical, those Ren and Martin thing that we tend to miss in these online meetings, but you kept a good note of it. So thank you so much for that. Next up is the best evaluator. Well, among the three great evaluators, that is Distinguished Toastmaster Rohan, Toastmaster Mohit, and Distinguished Toastmaster Archita, it was a close competition. I'm sorry, I'm not being able to share the screen with you all so I can show how close the competition was. But Distinguished Toastmaster Archita just won it by a small margin, but she was fantastic as the other two evaluators as well. So congratulations to Distinguished Toastmaster Archita. Moving on to the best.
Thank you so much, Mr. Silent President.
Thank you so much, GTM Archita. Moving on to the table topic speaker, the best table topic speaker. And the best table topic speaker is yours truly, Toastmaster Rahul. Thank you so much for people who enjoyed my table topic. And there are also other speakers who did a great job and were very close, but I just got it this time. Moving ahead, we have the best role player. Now we have three options to, if you remember, we had three options to select. And I was so confused that whom should I give it to? The Toastmaster of the day, who was so creative, the general evaluator who was so insightful, and the Toastmaster table topic master who was so spot on with the topics and to the comebacks after the topics. So what I did was I closed my eyes and didn't trust any of those points. I don't know whom I voted, but the best role player went to our Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Deepak Ved.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Toastmaster Deepak, you were fantastic, except for the last video that you showed to all of us. And moving on to the best speaker. We had fantastic speeches, I must say. For me, every speaker was the best speaker, but on paper today, the best speaker was our Vice President Membership, Toastmaster Gurpreet Singh.
Thank you everyone, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Gurpreet, for delivering that wonderful speech, and to Toastmaster Naren and Toastmaster Anirban as well. You all were fantastic. Well, this marks the end of today's meeting, and just a small announcement, that is on Monday at 8 p.m. we have the finale of the tug of words, that is the debate organized by the Executive Committee of Kolkata Toastmasters Club. There are two teams who have qualified for the finale, and we have the finals on Monday. I request all the members in this meeting, all the participants, to please be there, and I'm sure that you're going to have a wonderful time. To all the team that couldn't make it, please try to be in the meeting, in that finale, so that we can give you all your e-certificates over there. So that is it from today, and thank you so much for being a part of this meeting, and we see you next Friday, 7 p.m. Thank you so much.